Welcome students. In last few videos, we are discussing about the different types of the diseases which are caused to the silkworm larva. Now, already in previous few videos, we are discussing about the life cycle. And for getting the silk, we are interested in the third stage, that is the pupal case. We are interested in the pupal case of the silk moth. So here, from this video, we started to study the post-harvesting process of cocoons and preparation of cocoons for marketing. So here, when we are harvested the cocoons, we are harvest the cocoons and we are going to select the quality of cocoons during the process of harvesting the cocoons. Okay, so after harvesting the cocoons, the next step is preparation of the silk. Okay, so here there are various successive methods or processes are there and by which we get the silk material or silk. Okay, so initially we have to harvest the cocoons, and after harvesting the next few steps are there. So after harvesting of the cocoon, the process of unwinding of a single long thread from the cocoon, that is known as reeling. Okay, so here we study the process of reeling. So in case of reeling, what we are doing? We are just unwinding the single long thread. Single long thread. And we are going to just unwind the single long thread from the cocoon. And that process of unwinding the single long thread of silk from the cocoon, we call it as the reeling. Okay, but we are not directly go towards the reeling. Before the process of reeling, there are many steps. So before reeling and after harvesting of the cocoon, there are many steps. Okay, and we can say that the steps, for example, stippling, drying, storing, cooking, boiling, deflossing and reeling. These are the different steps which come after the reeling. Sorry, before the reeling. And since we call them as the methods, we are going to use before the reeling. And there are many other methods, for example, re-reeling, twisting, finishing, okay, which is just takes place after the process of reeling. So here, the cocoons when collected, when the cocoons get sorted, and when we are selected the good quality of cocoons, we proceed all those cocoons for the process of reeling. And actually, it starts from the first step, that is the stippling. Okay, so the first one, that is the stippling. What is stippling? See, stippling is a process of the cocoon drying. Okay, here in case of stippling, we are interested to kill the pupa which is present inside the cocoon. Suppose this is a cocoon. Inside that cocoon, the pupa is present. Now that pupa, which is the third stage in the life cycle, if we are not going to disturb this pupa, it will convert itself into the adult. Okay, So when it is get converted into adult, it try to emerge out. It just pierce that particular cocoon and try to come outside the cocoon. Okay. And when it comes outside, we call it as the adult. But we have to escape all these steps. And since we are only interested in this pupal case, see, this pupal case is the cocoon in which actually we are interested. Okay, so before the emergence of adult, we are follow the process of stifling. So in process of stifling, we are going to dry the cocoon. Okay, we are going to dry the cocoons. Now, how we are going to dry the cocoon? There are many steps, or there are different types of the steps or methods to dry the cocoon. And when we dry the cocoon, actually the pupa which is present inside the cocoon, that will die. And as such a cocoons, we are used for the process of drilling. Okay, now we are concentrated on what is stifling. There are three different ways or three different methods of stifling which indicated here. The first method, that is known as sun drying method. Second method is known as steam stifling method. And the third method is known as hot air stifling method. See, this is the first one. In case of the sun drying method, we are directly exposed the cocoons to the sunlight. The name itself indicates that we are going to expose the cocoons to sunlight, and since the name sun drying, and when we are going to expose the cocoons directly to the sunlight, the pupa which is present inside that cocoon, it will die. And for this process, the freshly harvested cocoons we have to expose to the bright sunlight for longer duration. Okay, it requires or the long time is required. And we are going to directly expose the cocoons to the sunlight. So that is known as sun drying method. The second method is known as steam stiffening. So in this method, we are going to use the fresh cocoons, and we are exposed all those cocoons directly over the hot bed steam. Okay, for a particular period. Okay, so here we are using the hot bed steam. So which is the method, or what is the what happened in this steam stifling method? So here we are using the hot bed steam, and we are directly exposed the cocoons to this hot bed steam, and due to the steam, the whatever the pupa which are present inside the cocoon, they get killed. Here the time required, okay, is different as compared with the time required here in the sun dry. Okay, now the cocoons may be stifled in a basket if they are present in a small quantity, or we can also use the barrel or a large chamber if the cocoons they are present in a large number. If you have very few quantity of the cocoons, so in case of the few cocoons, we are using basket for steam stifling. And if you have large quantity of cocoons, you may use some specific type of barrels, or you may use the chambers. Okay, so we are using the either the baskets or we are using the chambers. Now After the process of stem stifling, we are going to store the cocoons for 1 month. Okay. So it is possible to preserve the cocoons which are undergoing the process of stem stifling for 1 month. We can store the cocoons for 1 month after the process of stem stifling. Then the third method is there, which is known as hot air stifling. Here we are directly use the hot air. The name itself indicate that we are using the hot air. And when we are using the hot air, the pupa which is present inside the cocoon, that is get dry. And in this case, we are going to store the cocoons for longer duration. Okay. Means here, in case of stem stifling, we are only preserve them up to 1 month. But if the cocoons, they are dry, by the method of hot air stifling, we can store them for a longer duration. Okay, so it depends. So these are the three different methods how we are going to dry or how we are going to kill the specific pupa which is present inside the cocoon. And either we use the infrared rays, cold air, radio baggages, or we may use the poisonous gas. These are the remaining other methods, which in addition to these three methods we can use to kill the pupa. Okay, so this is about the stifling. After stifling the cocoons, we get the different types of cocoons we get after the harvesting of the cocoons. For example, there are normal cocoons, slightly defective cocoons, highly defective cocoons, double cocoons. Okay, so it is necessary to reject the defective cocoons. And when we are going to sort the cocoons, means when we are going to select the normal one and we are making the groups of double cocoon separately, we are preparing the groups like normal cocoons, slightly defective cocoons, double cocoon, that is known as sorting of cocoons. Now, sorting of cocoons, which is carried out mainly for the double cocoon, okay, then the cocoons which are actually with thin shell, sometimes the cocoons are there which bears the dead pupa. So it is necessary to remove such a type of cocoon which possesses the dead pupa. Sometimes the cocoons are dirty, sometimes they are with the loose shell, sometimes very thin and transparent shell is there. Okay, so we have to sort out all such types of the cocoons, and we are only selected the good cocoons. And when the good cocoons are selected, we call them as the normal cocoons. The color of the cocoon, which is commonly depend on the silkworm strain, which is reared in our sericulture unit. Now, beside the color, there are certain different colors. For example, golden yellow, flesh yellow, crimson, bamboo leaf color, green color. Okay, so the color pigment of the cocoon, which is present particularly in the sericene. In last video, we already discussed about the sericene. So it is a type of protein which is present in the silk. Okay, so the color color pigment which gives the color to the silk thread, that is present particularly here in the sericene. In the cocoons of domesticated silkworms, they are of various shapes, not only the color. Again, now we are interested here in the shape also. Some of the cocoons, they are oval in shape, some of them they are round in a shape, or they are spindle in a shape. So there are variety or various sizes, shapes of the cocoons which are present. Okay, so this is about the salting of cocoon. So here in salting of cocoon, we are interested in the good quality of cocoons, means the normal cocoons. Okay, the color of the cocoon, which is depend on the color pigment which are present here in the sericene, and the shape. Okay, again they are of variety of shape. Okay, so all this is about the sorting of cocoons. Thank you.